Hello animators, Crystal Page here for a model bench. So as you can see, you choose the vote in my YouTube channel and I said it and I posted it in February 15 or 4 like that. And as you can see here, so you chose the modeling Minecraft character tutorial. But I want the fish instead. But you choose the character tutorial, so we're gonna do this video and this is it. So let's do this. So first of all, you need to create a model, a new model right here. And as you can see, this is the main control, and I'm pressing the left mouse and this is the right mouse. So you see this white texture, this is texture, and this is the main texture or editing texture thing. Not editing at all, just choosing the blocks as you editing. So you click the texture, and as you can see, the default texture is here. So we're gonna replace the texture, right click, and replace the texture. Find your skin or your own skin in your desktop or some of your files. So I'm gonna use Remy's skin because I tell him that I need to remodel his human character, and it's just a thing to me. So I'm gonna choose Remy's skin. So here we are, the Remy's skin. I forgot to say, if the texture is this texture panel, if this is not showing in your model bench, just click in the top of the right corner of your screen or Control E. Then next, create a block right here, add block, second layer of the panel thing, and you see a block. You see a block, when you rotate it, you see a block is kind of an eel, like an eel. And the blue thing, that the front, right, top, bottom, left, back is here. So we're gonna move here. Or we're not gonna use body first because body is important. Oh, I forgot to say, hide shape. As you can see, the element hide shape. In the elements, you need to rename the new part to a body. This is the panel of the object or folder, and this is the main object. So in MineImator, if you import this, this body is only showing and not this new shape. So click the new shape and press the middle of the tree. As you can see, this edit length, edit XYZ, and edit width, weight and height, and this is the main move. So we're gonna move this to the corner of your body skin. Here in the corner body skin, after you set this to your body skin or move, edit the length into your skin, and this one is to the bottom of your skin. And that's all. After doing this, you see that this item is floating. So we're gonna click a transformation tool to see what is the main pivot offset or thing. So we're gonna choose a pivot offset. Click, or I mean slide this arrow to a right or left. Yes, right or left, and put it into the bottom of the surface of this, like a blender stuff thing. And yeah, after put it is here, make sure that this left or right arrow is here, and after that click the body and click the bend option, then click the bend XYZ because the body is supposed to be bent at all of the rotation points. So we're gonna enable this, click the show option of the bend of XYZ, but I'm gonna choose Y because of the perfect bend of this. So I'm gonna bend this to default angle to 62. As you can see, the main bend is in the bottom of your character body, so that's kind of it for me. So I mean, that's not a main idea. So come to the in the bottom of the inherit bend angle, you'll see a part upper, lower, back, front, left, right. So we're gonna choose upper because it's a body, so upper can only bend, so we're gonna choose the upper. Now click the offset text, and not click, just hold and click and set it to the right, and the pivot offset is now moving. So we're gonna choose number 6 because this is the main middle of your body. Then after that, custom bend size, it's the number 4, so that means we're gonna adjust it to number 10. or it depends to your skin. If you have a block here or something, set it to number 8. But I'm sure that you hate those bands, so I'm gonna prefer to number 8. But for me, number 10 because of my skin. So after that, that's all. Make a perfect bench. Then click the 88 number 20. So you see the body is kind of have a limited bend. It depends to you. So I'm gonna choose the 75. So I'm gonna choose 75 to 75 because 75 is my favorite. If 75 to perfect bend limit. Next, you bend X. Bend on X axis, and you see that this bend is kind of I remember this shape. Okay, now I remember. So we're gonna put it into zero. So we're gonna click issue a. I need to bend my body. Yes, I see. So we're gonna click this to 130. So 130 and to the left negative 130. And after that, you have a limit. I'm gonna click this partition Z. And on the range of the Z, you should set this to 60. So the bend body is supposed to always 60 below, you know. And negative 60. And that's all. Oh wait, I pressed the wrong button. So after that, you need to extrude your body. I mean, the 3D thing, or the perfect 3D thing, it bends to your skin, right? So we're gonna choose, or we're gonna copy the skin into the desktop. So make sure that you have a paint.net. Download it in the Windows Store, or buy it, or download the Kraken paint.net if you want though. So I'm using the Kraken thing, or the downloadable illegal, sorry. So we're gonna choose the Rummy skin and control copy, and set this Rummy skin to Rummy's skin items. After this, hold this and open with paint.net, and the paint.net will show. So after this, control and scroll to zoom your unzoom your image. This is the item, so that means we're gonna clear this space for the 3D hair. Clear 3D hair. Yes, and don't delete this though because we're gonna use it. So we're gonna copy the shoes, or his shoe, show copy. I forgot this is the item, so we're gonna delete this. Oh, I missed something. Delete it. And yeah, done. And after this, do we have any extra thing? Nothing. So that's also control save if you're done into your item texture. So we're using this second thing. So we're gonna import or add texture in the ModelBench. Add texture and choose your Rummy's item skin. Then after that, the item skin is here. See, it's here. So we're gonna click the body. Make sure you click the body and add the 3D plane. That means it's just a plane. And after that, click, and you see the texture is kind of eel or something in 3D that's super extrude. So in the texture panel, you need to move this to a half of the hoodie. I mean the jacket, because this is my type of my this is my type of my rigging. So we're gonna choose this to here. Yes, and 100% don't move the item, because if you move the item, the bendable thing 3D is not gonna work, or gonna crash or something or eat. So we're gonna use the pivot offset is the main thing that you need to move. So I know you can move this, so yeah, let's start. And I don't know how to use this size, so we're gonna use scale. Make this 0.5. oh, disable this and 0.5. then after this, set the Z pivot offset to front, or it's your choice to use this. Then use this X. Wait, this jacket is super odd to me, so we're gonna choose 0.25 and control Z. So it says 7.9, so I'm gonna make 8. Perfect. This negative 2. Now we have a first 3D item thing. Then select the item and control D to duplicate the item. Then move the item to side of the hoodie again and move using the X. And done. Number 1. And now let's try the body bend. And as you can see, the body item is now perfectly doing fine in the bend thing. Then after that, default angle is still perfect but still a glitchy inside, because I don't know if Mimi can fix this, but still, yeah, cool. And the band Z, still perfect. So we're done in the 3D body. Then now we're gonna add a new, oh, control S again. We're gonna add a new, I mean, not a new, just a left and right arm. We're gonna add the left arm and right arm. Press the add block. Add part. Turn the add part into a R, or it's a rename, or right arm. And now we're gonna move the main to top. Wait, we're gonna click this to the limit of the moving pixel. We're gonna use a position number 10 and use the X into a 6. Negative 6. And now in the right arm, in a folder, add the block, and you'll see a block. In airport, your right arm, the right arm is the my English is broken again. So we're gonna move this to here. After moving this, use pivot offset. After using the pivot offset, you're done. Control S again. Now we're gonna enable the band in the right arm. Click the right arm folder and click the X. Only X. Only X, because you have an X. Recipe to the single. Yo. So we're gonna use the X band, and you see the top band is bending. So we're gonna use the lower. And now, yes, perfect. Wait, this is not supposed to be. So we're gonna pair this to 0. And yeah. That's all. And move the pivot offset to the main middle of your character. So we're gonna choose negative 4, and bend the body. If the bend is perfect, I mean the right arm, yes, this is perfect and perfectly fine. So that's the main, I mean that's the perfect bend of the right of your right arm. So we're gonna add a new block again. I look like a stupid. And click it to the sleeve of your character. If you have a sleeve, we're gonna use this to the 2 pixel height and 2x4. Yes. And yes. Now the block is here. You need to scale this. Disable the tool snapping. Scale this into a 1.1 or maybe 0.5. So I'm gonna use 1.05. And move the pivot offset again and click the enable tool snapping. And yeah, you're done. You have a sleeve in your skin. And now, click the right arm, duplicate, control D, rename the right arm to the left arm, and move the item to the next of your arm and next of your body. And yeah, voila! That's all. And make sure that the left arm goes to the bottom of the texture, because, you know, might be a crazy thing to do. And the texture of the sleeve, move this. If you move this to the 3D item, you may see the left, right, back and front, but the bottom is not 3D. Or if you want to add that texture in the top of bottom of this, and yeah, just add or copy this top and bottom, just block. Don't use the skin, main skin, because it might be a cringy to see. So I'm gonna put this to and I mean the bottom of the freaking thing. Okay, so you'll see the image or a texture here. We're gonna add a new 3D plane. Rotate this and select this to logo. Then now scale this into 0.5. Oh, the snapping tool, this is called snapping tool 0.5. Now use the snapping tool again, enable snapping tool, and move this to your, you know, wait, it's to extrude again. Disable snapping tool 0.25, then enable snapping tool again, and move this to your logo, and that's all. So that's how remodeling do. So in the rest, I'm kind of dizzy today, so I'm gonna finish this without speaking. And good luck! Guys, and we're finally done at this rig, I mean this model. So the bed is fixed and perfect, the hair is perfect, and the head is perfect again. So yeah, that's all how to rig the model of your human. But if you want to add some bendable thing like a wrist or the foot, add it in your own wrist. So yeah, that's all, and thanks for watching.